Hi, I'm Edward, and I want to give you a bit of background today on alignment and what it is and my journey and how you can start your journey of alignment as well. So we're here in Crete, where I'm lucky enough to spend a lot of time, and I run a lot of my workshops and retreats from here. And every day these days I'm waking up with a sense of flow, a sense of longing for creativity, a sense of pleasure. I experience joy every day. I experience a lot of love, a lot of connections with communities and people that I work with. And I feel very blessed, and I feel really, really grateful for the life that I'm experiencing. But this wasn't always the case at all. And there are a few moments in my life that really marked me and really kind of marked turning points for me towards where I am today. So I remember, for example, 7 years ago, I was living in a city that I didn't really connect with. I knew no one, and I was in a job that I didn't really want to do. And I remember walking home from this office job that I didn't like, and it was raining, and it was this full of high-rise buildings everywhere. And I was walking home, and I remember stopping and just realizing, wow, you know. And I had this bubble of sadness like rising up inside of me, and I remember thinking, wow, I've really lost the sense of flow that I had before, the joy that I was experiencing before in like perhaps childhood, perhaps early teens. I'd lost that. I lost the wonder and the awe at the world, and I was either completely lost, and I didn't know what I was doing, where I was going. I was living this life, or I was going towards this image of a life that I thought I wanted, and actually it really wasn't me. So that kind of marked the first turning point in my life, where I started to really think, okay, what do I want, you know? What's important for me? And at the time I had these two ideas of either becoming a personal trainer or going into charity, or working in charities. And I followed my heart down the fitness route first, which has led me kind of into the work that I do today, which, funny enough, is also based, I also run a charity called the Thrive Foundation. And another moment, a few years later, when I remember I was diagnosed with HIV a few months actually after this moment, and I moved to London, and I was kind of following my heart in a small sense. I was meeting some coaches and some healers and some mentors, and I was going on a few courses, and at the same time I was leading a destructive life. I was throwing myself into work. I was quite disconnected from my family, from real friends, real connections. I struggled to make real contact with the world and with people, and I was partying quite a lot, and I was not taking care of myself at all. And I was really not listening to this voice. I was getting stronger and stronger and bigger and bigger. So I was living this dual life for many years. And I remember one morning, while I was partying in this club, or entering this club, and like maybe like 4 or 5 a.m. and it was light outside, and I had this moment of really intense clarity. Like I saw what was around me for the first time. I really saw where I was, and I saw people around me drunk, and I saw myself, and I had a similar moment of, what am I doing? You know, this is not me. This is not in alignment with who I am. Like, I remember who I am. I got glimpses of it as a child, you know, and that's really what I want to be. That's joyful and playful, and I want to have real connections, and I want to have real intimacy, and I want to have real pleasure, and I want to experience joy. And that was a second moment that changed a lot of things for me, and it led me to listen to this part of myself a lot more, going on more courses, meeting more people, like opening myself, going on a journey of personal transformation, of personal growth, of personal healing, which led me eventually to become an alignment mentor, which is what I do today. So where I help people experience more joy, more flow, more creativity, to really bring their heart's desires and longings to life by first diving in to the perhaps uncomfortable layers of themselves, and transforming those layers, transforming those negativities or old negative emotions or old patterns or ways of being, transforming them into what they really desire, into their heart's longing, and really creating love, creating lives in which they can wake up and have this sense of fulfillment and gratitude every day, because that's what we can all achieve and it's all inside of us if we give ourselves the space to stop, observe where we're at and take the time and put the energy, the effort, the space into ourselves and this part of ourselves, rather than the day-to-day, the same thoughts, the same feelings, the same work, the same ways of being. But if you stop and breathe and connect and start to listen, then we can find a space of alignment with this deeper self, with this deeper part of ourselves. And from then we can heal, we can transform, and we can create whatever our hearts desire.